אני לא אתערב לך בהרצאה, מבטיח.
אתה יכול להתערב, אני מה זה התערבו.
אם רוצים שיהיו...
We just finished Nedarim today.
Oh, my grandpa. Marie Burnett's beer. Yes. She was
No. You know, my mother never had a car. My father died young.
Alma tu cachet.
Please sit down, please. Please, if you need the translation, you can come to the front and ask for the proper equipment, please. Good evening. Welcome to the International Conference on Sephardic North African and Middle Eastern Communities in North America. ברוכים הבאים לכינוס הבינלאומי על הקהילות הספרדיות, הצפון אפריקאיות והמזרח תיכוניות באמריקה הצפונית. Il me fait plaisir de vous souhaiter à la soirée d'ouverture de ce colloque international sur les communautés séfarades en Amérique du Nord. Mr. Sylvain Abitbol, président de la communauté séfarade unifiée du Québec. David Kay, président sortant, Fédération CGA. Mr. Ziv Nevo Kuhlman, consul général of Israel in Montreal. Professor Ira Robinson, Director, Concordia University Institute for Canadian Jewish Studies. Professor Yaron Harel, Chairman of the Academic Committee, Dahan Center, Bar-Ilan University. It is a great pleasure to open this conference here in Montreal in the Concordia University. For us, at the Dahan Center, this is the 35th International Conference on Jewish Communities around the world. Many were conducted in Israel, that a significant number were in cooperation with universities around the world and were held in various countries such as the Sorbonne in France, University of Bologna in Italy, University of São Paulo in Brazil, Navarra University in Spain, University of Maryland in the United States, University of Tbilisi in Georgia, University of Rabat in Morocco, and University of Skopje in Macedonia. We are grateful today for this wonderful opportunity to be here at Concordia University, who is hosting this conference in cooperation with the University of Quebec and Montreal University. Joining us once again is the Ashkelon Academic College of Israel, who have become our steady partners. Our conference deals, of course, with the Sephardic communities of North America, and we cannot ignore the fact that the first Jewish settlers in the United States at the beginning of the 17th century and settled in Newport, Rhode Island, were from the Spanish Portuguese community. And in our days, when we examine the immigration of Jews from Sephardic communities to North America, we find entire communities which were established and well prospered impressively. One example is the 20,000 Jews who emigrated from Halab and Damascus in the early 20th century. If we follow their absorption and development, we find a community with established and well-organized institutions living together geographically and culturally. A central characteristic of this community is the high level of cohesion, which is expressed also through their preservation of the Middle Eastern culture and living under rabbinical leadership. When we observe the Moroccan Jews who emigrated to Montreal, we discover a very developed community whose members are integrated both socially and economically in the population of Montreal. This successful absorption and integration will be described, I believe, and analyzed in Dr. Dina Asulin-Stillman's lecture, which she has called Toi Quebec, tu m'as pris dans tes bras. And she continues by saying this is the fulfillment of the American dream for the Jewish Moroccan immigrant. Unfortunately, this is not the same description that we had when we discussed other communities and other conferences. And if we are talking about Canada, then I, as a Jew and an Israeli, I'm touched and impressed with the special treatment and support of the Canadian government had by Prime Minister Harper towards the Jewish community and its struggle against anti-Semitism. I would also like to point out the Canadian government's deep solidarity with the suffering of the many Jews from many Arab countries, not all of them, but many of them, who due to terrible conditions such as pogroms, hangings, seizure of properties, and insecurity about their safety and futures, had to leave their countries of origin. The Canadian Parliament has been the first to join the American Congress in its decision that any discussion on refugee reparation for the Palestinians must include discussions on compensation for Jews from Arab countries who had to leave and lost their property and wealth. And finally, we, the organizers of this conference, wish to express our gratitude to all the people and institutions who worked hard in preparation of this conference. First of all, our thanks to the academic committee who worked endlessly in preparing the academic program. Thank you each personally, Professor Ira Robinson, Concordia University, Professor Yaron Harel, Bar-Ilan University, Professor Shimon Sharvit, Director of the Academic College, Ashkelon Academic College in Israel, Professor Saba Nicolaini, Concordia University, Professor Robert Schwarzwald of Montreal University, and Professor Yolande Cohen, Université du Québec, Montreal. It was also my honor to be part of this committee. Our thanks to the institutions you represent, each one of you. A special thanks again to Professor Ira Robinson, who has accompanied us from the onset of this project and gave his attention to each detail, from the lectures, lecture halls, hotels, meals, and almost everything. And he worked endlessly to make this conference a success. I would like to express my gratitude to the General Consul of Israel in Montreal, Mr. Ziv Nevo, for the special reception he has prepared for us on Tuesday evening. Our thanks also to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Israel for their support. And now, really a special thanks to the Sephardi community of Quebec, the President, Mr. Sylvain Habitbol. General Director, Mr. Robert Habitbol. Dr. Sonia Sara Lipzig, Daniel Glantz, and Benjamin for their warm hospitality and for arranging this evening's gala dinner. Thank you very much. I would like also to thank the Jewish Israeli Congress, their president, Mr. Vladimir Slutsker, and General Director, Mr. Michel Gourari, for their support to the Dahan Center. Now I have also the pleasure to mention that the presence of very, very important guest with us, Mr. Harry Blomfield. A great philanthropist that everywhere in Israel you can find also his contribution, starting from the Ort Net High School in Israel, up to universities like Hebrew University, and you could really continue with many, many projects. Thank you for being with us. And last, but not least, I would like to thank my staff at the Dahan Center, Bat-El Harris, Ayelet Chazan, and special thanks to our coordinator, Ms. Ora Kobalkovsky, who has done a tremendous job in organizing this conference. And I would like to end by wishing all of us a successful and fruitful conference. Thank you very much. And now it is with great pleasure that I invite Mr. Sylvain Habitbol, the president of the Unified Sephardi Community of Quebec, to greet us, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Just a small clarification. It's not David Cape who will address us tonight. It will be Mr. David Amiel, incoming first president, vice president of the Federation CJA. You know, for those people who are involved in the community, we wear many kippot. Tonight, I'm wearing the kippah of the president of the CSUQ. But last time I met Shimon Chayon in Israel, I was wearing another kippah as co-president of Justice for Jews from Arab countries. And I really would like to thank you, Shimon, for everything you did at the Knesset to vote, to adopt the law that mentioned the date, the official day of November the 30th, as the day of Sephardic history. It is quite appropriate that this conference is happening now. At the same time that within the Sephardic community, we have made in-depth analysis of the transformation, the metamorphosis of the Sephardic community here in Montreal. We've been here 50 years, but 50% of Sephardic Montreal are born in this country. And there is a difference. We are still with the mentality of North Africa, but the upcoming generation was born here. And we are trying to understand what are the levers, what is the leverage, what are the pushing points that will make this community even stronger within the general community. We've done an in-depth analysis to the point where we want to do a much, much more intense analysis with doctoral studies to understand the Sephardic community here in Montreal. And certainly, it's going to be probably a study that will take us a year to accomplish, and we'll probably share it with you guys, because it is a tremendous experiment that will be the object of a full-fledged analysis. The community here has changed, indeed. It is a vibrant community, mostly from Morocco. We came in about 50 years ago, approximately, but we are all over the place. To give you an idea, the Jewish General Hospital raised $15 million from the Sephardic community. However, the foundation, the Federation, TJA, raised only a few million dollars from the Sephardic community. We're trying to understand why this is happening. I had a call from Larry Cutler, who is the executive director of United Talmud Torah. And he said, Sylvain, the majority of my kids at school are Sephardic, but they know nothing about the history. Why don't we do something about coming with a curriculum to test pilot it at my school, and then we can apply it across the board? So these are the type of challenges that we are handling, that we are juggling with, to understand and to answer, to position this community for the next 20 years. It is very important to us to understand that the community is changing. The core Ashkenazi community, which is a foundation of the Montreal Jewish community, is getting old. We're not sure that the children will continue to contribute to the campaign. And the Sephardic community is growing, as well as the religious community. We see that the Sephardic community is becoming more religious. How do we integrate this element of the community within the Jewish community? Those are the questions that we're asking ourselves. And hopefully, in a year from now, we hope to have some answers to communicate to you and share with you. But definitely, I think we are going to be a vibrant part of this community to bring strength, unity to the general community. Donc, sur ces paroles, j'aimerais vous souhaiter une très bonne conférence, an excellent evening. Welcome to all of you, and enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sylvain Abitbol. I have to apologize because in the beginning I didn't mention David Amiel. I was given another name, but we are really pleased and honored by the presence of Mr. David Amiel, Premier Vice President, LUFCJA. Please come and greet us. Thank you.
Alors, bonsoir. Au nom de la Fédération CIGEA, je suis très heureux de parler de vous en cette veille de la conférence internationale sur les communautés juives séfarades d'Afrique du Nord et du Moyen-Orient en Amérique du Nord. À la Fédération CIGEA, nous sommes ravis de pouvoir participer à cette célébration de la diversité, de la culture et de l'héritage juif de Montréal. Nous sommes également ravis d'avoir la possibilité de contribuer à des discussions et des échanges d'idées dans le cadre de cet événement. Bien que nous provenions de différents coins de la planète, nous formons tous une seule et même communauté. Inherent in our mission at Federation CJA is promoting diversity and securing a bright future for our Jewish community, and we are fortunate to benefit from the inspiring work that the Communauté Séfarade Unifiée du Québec, the CSUQ, does on a daily basis. Promoting our rich heritage and celebrating Jewish vitality in Montreal throughout the year through a spectrum of cultural offerings. Thank you to the myriad of cultural institutions who have come together to make this meeting of the minds possible. À la fin de cette conférence, je vous inviterai à découvrir la vaste programmation offerte par ces organisations tout au long de l'année. Et je souhaite de tout cœur que cet événement vous encourage à continuer de soutenir la diversité de la culture juive qui est présente au sein de notre incroyable communauté. You've all heard the old Talmudic phrase of planting a tree. To paraphrase, it says, plant a tree now and you will yield fruit for generations. Well, we here at Federation CJA believe this incredible cross-pollination is going to yield a tremendous amount of fruit. Nous sommes fiers de participer à des événements comme celui-ci. Ces événements nous permettent de nous épanouir, de nous instruire et de travailler activement au mieux-être de toute la communauté. Kol hakavod, merci de votre attention et bonne fin de soirée.
Thank you, Mr. Amiel. When we started to think about this conference, I called Mr. Akiva Tor, who's working in the Foreign Ministry Office in Israel, who's in charge of our Sobil, besides other jobs and other tasks that he's in charge also of the contact and working together with Jewish communities. He told me, just call, give a call, and I'm going to talk to Mr. Ziv Nevo, and you will get a very, very warm reception. And he was right. When I called Mr. Ziv Nevo, right away he said, I'm opening my house for you, and you will come to a special reception during your conference. And I have the pleasure to call Mr. Ziv Nevo to greet us, please.
Erev Tov, bonsoir, good evening everyone. Dr. Ochayon, thank you very much for your warm introduction. The other part of the story is, yes, you've contacted Akiva Tor, and he, in his turn, called me, and he said something that I would like to share with you tonight. He said, how lucky I am that the Dahan Center has chosen Montreal as the place for this conference, and how lucky I am to meet all of you. Je suis vraiment chanceux de vous avoir tous ici ce soir, and I'm quite happy that you chose to come here to Montreal, especially during this time of the year. You know, it's much more pleasant here when it's plus 30 and not minus 30. But also when we talk about the contribution of Sephardi communities in North America, I think, as you've heard from Sylvain and from David, there is no place, I think, in North America, perhaps in the world, where you can see right now the contribution of the Sephardi community. Quand on parle de la diversité culturelle, when we talk about cultural diversity, things that are so important to this country and to this province, to the city and of course to the Jewish community. If you talk about Jewish continuity, Israel awareness, Jewish education, all of these things are very present among the Sephardi community of Quebec and its contribution to this community as a whole. This is something that I've witnessed in my 11 months period here. So I salute you all for coming all the way from Israel to Montreal, and I salute the Jewish community and its leadership for its diversity and its different communities. The second point I wanted to share with you is not part of the conference, but I am representing the State of Israel. So I would also like to say a few words about the contribution of the Sephardi community in Israel, which is very important. As we all know, the Sephardi community is present in all aspects of Israel in our culture. First of all, the way we speak Hebrew, mazal, in our political life, in our cultural life, academic life, as you will hear from brilliant people who came, brilliant professors and scholars who came all the way from Israel, basically in our music, and I have to say happily, Biglal Shani Polani, in our food. I'm very grateful for a Sephardi, North African, and Middle Eastern contribution to Israeli cuisine would not be the same if it only had gefilte fish.
In a pita.
So,
in a pita.
In a pita, in schnitzel. So with this happy note, I would like to wish you all a very pleasant evening and a wonderful conference, and thank you all for coming to Montreal. Merci beaucoup, bonsoir.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ziv Nevo. Talking about being lucky, well, as I said before, we organize many, many international conferences all over the world, as a matter of fact. But sometimes you are lucky when you meet someone like Professor Ira Robinson. He is in Montreal, but you feel like you are working together with him in Tel Aviv, in Bar Ilan University, because he was really inside the story in every detail, everything, from the academic level to the technical level. Everything was done and prepared together with his encouragement. And I have really the pleasure to invite you to speak and to greet us. Professor Ira Robinson.
Comme le rabbin du Talmud nous dit, Potrim bichvod achsania. Nous commençons par donner nos remerciements aux organisateurs de cette soirée de gala au commencement de notre colloque international sur les communautés séfarades d'Afrique du Nord et du Moyen-Orient en Amérique du Nord, c'est-à-dire la CESUC, la Communauté séfarade unifiée du Québec, son président, M. Sylvain Abitbol, Mme Danielle Glantz, directrice communication et publication, et spécialement Dr. Sonia Sara Lipsic, affiliée avec mon institut, qui a suggéré cette liaison entre Bar-Ilan et Concordia pour la première fois. Alai gam kein hachova hanima lomar bruchim habaim lachokrim mi-Israel, mi-Tzorfat, mi-Arzot Habrit umi-Canada שבאים להשתתף בכנס. Organizing an international conference is a complex undertaking, and there are many people who need to be acknowledged. Concordia University's Institute for Canadian Jewish Studies, which I have the honor of directing, was approached by the Aaron and Rachel Dahan Center for Culture, Society, and Education in the Sephardic Heritage at Bar-Ilan University to make this conference happen. And I begin my acknowledgments with my co-chair of the conference, Professor Yaron Harel, with Dr. Shimon Ohayon, director of the Dahan Center, with Professor Shimon Sharvit, rector of Ashkelon Academic College, and with Ora Kobolkovsky of the Dahan Center, who has done so much of the administrative work to make this conference into a reality. Of her, I can say in complete sincerity, Shali v'shalachem shalahu. In Montreal, the conference had the advantage of the good counsel and aid of my colleague and friend, Professor Yolande Cohen of l'Université du Québec à Montréal, whose field of research encompasses much of the theme of this conference, and also from Professors Robert Schwarzwald of l'Université de Montréal and Chaba Nicolegni of Concordia University. At Concordia's Institute for Canadian Jewish Studies, which is dedicated to the study of the Canadian Jewish experience in the broadest sense, and which supports a wide range of projects of local, national, and international interest, contributing to this growing field of inquiry, I would like to acknowledge the work of my assistants, Georgia Carter and Simony Holt. The subject matter of this international conference is a matter of growing academic interest and concern, but it is also one of those subjects that elicit great and genuine community interest. I hope and trust that this conference will serve to advance our understanding of a subject of great importance, even as it forges new connections between academics and their institutions, as well as between the academy and the community. Thank you, toda raba, merci beaucoup et bonne soirée.
Have so many speakers to continue. We have only one, Professor Yaron Harel. Professor Yaron Harel is the chairman of the academic committee at the Daham Center in Bar-Ilan University. This is not the first time that Yaron Harel is leading us in international conference. For him, it's already maybe the fifth time that he's leading us in these kinds of events. And he's really involved not only just organizing the conference. The main work is to be part of the editorial board for publishing the books that are usually follows the international conference. And he's really devoted to this work, and with his help, assistance, and leading, we managed to publish already a few books. And I have the pleasure to call Professor Yaron Harel, the chairman of the academic committee at the Daham Center.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs, אני אעשה הומאז' לעברית ואני אדבר בעברית. מרכז דהאן שם לו למטרה לקיים מדי שנה, כל פעם בארץ אחרת, כנס בינלאומי בשיתוף עם אוניברסיטה מקומית. עכשיו, שיתוף הפעולה הבינלאומי הזה מאוד חשוב, מכיוון שהוא משמש אמצעי למפגש בין חוקרים ישראלים לבין חוקרים
an encounter between researchers from Israel and from other countries throughout the world who share
המפגש הזה מפרה מעין כמוהו בין אם באמצעות הגשת פירות המחקר בדיונים בהרצאות ואם באמצעות הדיונים הבלתי פורמליים בין מושב אחד למשנהו. חשיבות נוספת יש לקיום הכנס בחו"ל הוא המפגש עם הקהילה המקומית. אחרי הכל, אני חושב שרובכם יודעים את זה, אנחנו החוקרים במדעי הרוח לא נהנים מאלפי קוראים של המחקרים שלנו, וכשאנחנו באים ומשמיעים את פרי המחקר שלנו בפני אנשי הקהילות שאת ההיסטוריה שלהם אנחנו חוקרים, את המורשת שלהם, את התרבות שלהם, אנחנו מוצאים קהל שצמא לשמוע מה אנחנו בעצם עושים. אני לא חושב שיש למתמטיקאים את הפריבילגיה הזאת, לפיזיקאים אין את הפריבילגיה הזאת, אבל לנו כאנשים שחוקרים היסטוריה ותרבות, יש את הפריבילגיה הזאת לפגוש את האנשים שאת המורשת שלהם אנחנו חוקרים. וההפריה היא הדדית, מצד אחד אנשי הקהילה רוצים לשמוע מה אנחנו מצאנו, מה אנחנו חקרנו, מאידך גיסא, הרבה פעמים אנשי הקהילות מעשירים אותנו במידע שהם נושאים איתם, במידע שיש להם, בדוקומנטים שהם מחזיקים אצלם, שאיננו נמצא בכל מקום אחר. בשנים שבהם אני מכהן כיושב ראש הוועדה האקדמית של מרכז דיאן, קיימנו כנסים מן הסוג הזה באיטליה, בגיאורגיה, בברזיל, במקדוניה, ולפני כן עשינו כנסים גם במרילנד, בפריז, במדריד. בעקבות כל כנס, אנחנו מפרסמים גם קובץ מאמרים שמבוסס על ההרצאות שנישאו בכנס. וזוהי תרומה אדירה למחקר. בעצם אנחנו קובעים את סדר היום המחקרי, גם לשנה שהייתה וגם לשנה שתבוא. וכל מחקר עתידי איננו יכול שלא להתייחס לקובצי המאמרים שלנו. כל זה לא היה אפשרי ללא שיתוף פעולה עם העמיתים מן האוניברסיטה המארחת השותפה. תראו, לפעמים כשהדובר האחרון מעריך בדברים שלו, אז כבר את זה אמרו ואת זה אמרו, אבל להגיד תודה צריך להגיד יותר מפעם אחת. ואני באמת ברשותכם רק רוצה כמה אנשים. הראשון הוא כמובן, ותודה מקרב לב לפרופסור, שהפך להיות ידיד שלי בסקייפ, פרופסור איירה רובינזון. איזה מזל שיש היום סקייפ. תראו שיתפנו פעולה כפי ששמעתם עם הרבה מאוד אוניברסיטאות, אבל כאן זה באמת היה שיתוף פעולה יוצא מן הכלל, תענוג צרוף, באמת תענוג צרוף היה לארגן יחד איתך את הכנס. אני מבקש גם להודות לפרופסור יולן כהן מאוניברסיטת מונטריאול על תרומתה החשובה לארגון הכנס הזה, ותודה מקרב לב לשותפינו במכללת אשקלון ובראשם פרופסור שמעון שרביט, ידידי הטוב. אמר כאן שמעון אוחיון ואמר תודה לכולם, אני חושב שצריך לומר גם לו תודה, באמת תודה רבה גדולה, שמעון והצוות, אורה קובלקובסקי, עבדו יומם ולילה, ואני באמת לא מגזים כאן, יומם ולילה, כדי שכל פרט שקשור לכנס הזה יהיה מושלם. אני מאחל לכולנו, כפי שנועם אוהב שאומרים, כנס פורה,
I wish us all conference. A fruitful conference
ומרחיב את הדעת. ערב טוב ותודה רבה.
And an enlightening one. Thank you very much. And good evening.
Thank you, Professor Arel. 500 years ago, as a matter of fact, more than 500 years, when the Jewish people, together also with Muslims, were expelled from Spain, they took with them a very special and unique heritage, the Andalus music. The Andalus music has accompanied us more than 500 years. It was taken, for example, to North Africa, to Morocco, not only just to the social life, but also to every ritual, religious ceremonies, everywhere. And I think one of the highest points, probably you heard the name Shirat HaBakashot, Shirat HaBakashot was also very, very well developed because of the Andalus music. And tonight, we have the honor and the pleasure to introduce special ensemble. Ensemble, also Jews and Muslims together. The ensemble is Soleil de l'Andalus de Montréal with the conductor, Mr. Khalil Muqaddam. And I'm inviting Mr. Khalil Muqaddam to say a few words about the Andalus music before we continue. Please.
Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Mesdames, Messieurs, bonsoir. Andalousie de Montréal a le plaisir d'être parmi vous ce soir pour vous présenter quelques morceaux de cette musique dont on dit qu'elle a été héritée depuis 500 ans, mais elle monte jusqu'au 9e siècle. Alors, avant de présenter les morceaux de musique qu'on va jouer, j'aimerais mettre quelques éléments de contexte que certainement vous connaissez, mais sont importants pour la continuité de la soirée. Et pour moi, ça s'intègre bien dans le thème de votre conférence internationale, qui est l'interculturalité et la multiculturalité. Alors,
Good evening. I've been chosen to do the translation into English. So, thank you for being with us this evening. I hope you're enjoying the music and these speeches as well. We want to interpret several classical pieces for you within the Andalusian music repertoire from Morocco. But before we begin playing, Dr. Khalil Muqaddam is going to put forward to us a few historical facts about the music in question that we're playing.
On raconte qu'il y a à peu près au 10e siècle, il y avait un orchestre qui composait de 200 personnes qui jouait pour un public qui devrait être composé de 1000 personnes à peu près. Pour moi, c'est un élément important, c'est le fait qu'il y ait 200 personnes sur une scène. Moi, je ne pourrais pas jouer, sincèrement, je ne pourrais pas diriger un tel orchestre. On est juste 7 et c'est très difficile d'orchestrer cela. Alors, imaginez 200 personnes qui jouent. Dans les textes du 16e siècle, ils disent qu'ils jouaient des ouds, comme mon instrument, des flûtes, des sortes de flûtes et des instruments de rythme. Alors, je vous laisse imaginer cette orchestration, comment elle est. Et le public, il était composé de 1000 personnes à peu près, de toutes les religions, je dirais.
It is told that there used to be an orchestra of over 200 musicians, both men and women, who played the oud, which is this Middle Eastern instrument, and also various wind instruments, which in Andalusian Spain reflected the popularity of this form of music. Its beginnings span from the medieval times, from the 8th century, reaching its height during the 12th and 13th century. Its interpretation continued throughout the rest of history up until today.
Alors, cette musique-là, elle a été créée en Andalousie et elle a traversé deux périodes qui sont très importantes que vous connaissez, la période de la Renaissance et la période de la période baroque. Alors, il y avait beaucoup de difficultés que vous connaissez, politiques, sociales, l'expulsion des musulmans et des juifs qui sont partis au Maghreb. Et malgré tout cela, vous et nous aussi, ce soir, on est en train de jouer cette musique et de la déguster. Ça, c'est très important pour moi.
Both Jewish and Muslim communities fervently kept this patrimonial heritage alive, despite political conflict, forcibly have it removed. Its sources come from early Christian and Gothic chants, Middle Eastern musical modes as well, and also local Jewish music before the 8th century, and also North African populations migrating north into Andalusia, in particular Berber populations.
Alors c'est pour cela, et c'est mon dernier mot, c'est pour cela que ce soir on a joué, si vous avez un peu prêté l'oreille au début, on a joué une musique instrumentale de laquelle sort l'hymne national espagnol. Et puis par la suite, on va jouer un petit morceau qui ressemble à la musique andalouse algérienne. Parce que, comme vous connaissez, il y a trois types de musique, algérienne, marocaine et le malouf de la Tunisie. Alors, on va jouer un morceau qui ressemble à la musique algérienne. Et à la fin, on va jouer un morceau qui ressemble à la musique africaine. C'est-à-dire les gens qui étaient partis en Espagne, ils ont composé des musiques qui ressemblent à une musique africaine, une musique berbère.
Three areas in particular, are seen as the source of Andalusian music, being the cities of Granada, Seville, and Valencia. After the Christian Spanish reconquered, this music settled in Morocco, and it carries the name Al-Ala. In Algeria, this music is called Sena, and Malouf in Tunisia.
Alors, je termine par présenter l'orchestre qui est un orchestre hybride, composé par aussi bien des musulmans que des juifs. Brahim Afeiloul à la clarinette. Souheil Mokadem au violon. Elvin Sebag au violon alto. Khalid Andalousi, notre chanteur. Driss Dormi au rythme tambourin ou tambourine. Un autre Sami Sebag au darbouka. Je vous souhaite une agréable soirée. Merci.